everybody, and welcome to Las Lomas High School for the boys' version of the Battle of the Creek. It's men's basketball here tonight, right here on Walnut Creek TV. I'm Anthony Schultz along with Brooke Kilgore. And Brooke, we got a couple of teams here in a crosstown rival. We've got the Northgate Broncos that are coming off a very good season. They've struggled so far. Of course, they lost all five starters from a year ago, but Jake Bowen's playing some good basketball for Northgate.
Jake Bowen is apparently the strong head leader of the Northgate Broncos. Senior here for the past 3 years. He's shown some incredible leadership qualities, and they're hoping to see that on the court tonight.
And for Las Lomas, they're a team that struggled last year, 8 up, 19 down. They've had three coaches in 4 years right now, so there's been a bit of a transition period, but 8 victories already in the season, so things are going pretty well. And the guy that's starring for them right now is Jake Davis.
Jake Davis, headstrong senior. You can see it all around. College decisions, we don't know where he's headed, but you can tell. Strong, strong shooter. He's their, you know, point guard out on the side. You can see him. He's their most reliable player, and he's just going to put on a show for us tonight and hopefully the show for all of Walnut Creek.
And could be playing D1 basketball before everything is decided.
Hopefully.
So that's it. We'll have the starting lineups and the opening tip-off when we come back on Walnut Creek TV. Okay, welcome back to Battle of the Creek here. The Las Lomas boys and the Northgate boys getting set to do battle in the Battle of the Creek. Let's send it downstairs now for the player introductions.
for Northgate High School. A junior, number 5, Daniel Looney. A junior, number 11, Jake Angus. A senior, number 20, Charlie Walters. A senior, number 24, CJ Lewis. And a senior, number 32, Jake Bowman.
All right, just moments away from tip-off. Starting lineups here, first for Northgate, Daniel Louie, Jake Andujas, Charlie Walters, CJ Agulis, and Jake Bowen. And for the home team, the Los Lomas Knights, Jake Davis, Colin Pangillian, and Mike Wood, Julian Voucher, and Drew Gozaleski to get the game started off. And they'll jump center here. Anthony Schultz along with Brooke Kilgore. And Brooke, this should be a good one. And it, I guess, a rivalry that dates back now to the early 70s.
Oh, my goodness. It's just something to always look forward to, these Knights and Broncos, and it could go either way.
All right. And the Broncos win the tip. They're in black. Knights, the home team, in the home whites. Opening possession of the ball game.
Defense! Defense!
And a long three-point shot off the front of the rim. No good. And the Knights clear.
All right, Jake Davis is headed in. We're going to see some good plays. Ooh, a nice tip right there.
Into the paint, amongst the trees, has it knocked away. Good defense on the interior by the Broncos.
It's a surprise this Broncos defense is here to step up.
Boy, good team defense right there on the baseline. And the Knights get the ball, almost lost it, now to the inside. In traffic, can't get the runner to go. And it is cleared by the Northgate. Agulis with the defensive board.
Just several blocks back to back. It's surprising that no points have been put in yet.
Driving against the taller player, can't get it to go. Good defense that time. And Agulis just couldn't get the shot to go, but really very aggressive going to the hole that time. The outside looking for that shot, high screen. Team still looking for the first basket. Banging bodies, turn, spin, puts it up, and draws the foul.
Way to play off that foul. I mean, seriously, just selling that point. As a quarterback, Michael Wood played for 4 years straight, and he just knows how to sell those penalties.
Took that right in, drew the contact, and Mike Wood now will shoot a pair of free throws. As Brooke just mentioned, the quarterback of the football team, so you know he's a good athlete, knocks down the first shot. And that is our first point of the ball game.
Just his impeccable height. I mean, this man is 6'8", and he's played this game for 4 years straight. He knows what he's doing.
Yeah, 6'8", he's even tall for a quarterback.
I know, right?
Hits that second one, 2-0 here, 6:45 to go in the opening quarter. And Los Lomas playing some full court press, and the defense, they poke it away. Wood gets it to a man in front of the court. Couldn't get the fast break. Good transition defense by the Broncos that time.
A little contained in that area. Oh, and it fell out of bounds.
Tried to get it inside to Wood. Had it poked away, but the Knights will maintain possession. Knights coming into today's play. 8-7 overall, 0-1 in the DFAL. Here's a pass to nobody in this one. They're going to have to try to get it up the sideline. They can't do it. Out of bounds to Northgate.
Los Lomas has every chance to win this game. I mean, that close game against Ocalani's last Friday, 52-54, shows that they know how to move this ball and work together as a team.
Yeah, they couldn't hit foul shots in that ball game, and they were missing a lot of layups, a game they really should have had. against the Dons. All right, here are the Broncos still looking for their first bucket of the ball game. Dribble drive to the inside, met by a trio of defenders. Open three-point shot, knocked down. And knocking that down is Daniel Louie from outside. And you can see the dribble penetration set that up. Going all the way, reverse layup score. Beautiful move. Pangilinan makes that shot, and boy, that was pretty.
I just like how they came back and responded straight to that ball. No hesitation, no delay. They were in and out before their second had even passed.
And you see Los Lomas with that full court press. They're going to do this all game long. Ball knocked away, and now they're going to get a kick ball situation.
So not soccer, guys, not soccer.
Well, they should recycle the shot clock after the kick ball. It'll be side out for the Broncos, and the Knights lead at 4-3. Broncos looking to take their first lead of the ball game right here, and this one kicked over. You can see that press. And then we got a foul here on the wing.
Surprising. That's also what killed him in that Akilani's game last week, is just foul after foul and allowing this team to be too rough sometimes. And they need to really tone that down in order to secure that ball more.
Louie looking for some room. Back on top it goes for the Broncos. Three-point shot off the rim. It hit both sides of the rim before spilling out. Good-looking shot there by Charlie Walters, but he couldn't get it to drop.
Jake Davis running it in. Hopefully he can make a play.
Off to Wood, who banks it home. Jake Davis gets the assist, and that was another where the whole drive to the basket set up the shot.
There's a clear connection between Davis and Wood right now. Clearly that tall man defense and the ability to make a smart play is just working really well for the Knights.
6-3, drive to the inside, count it, and a foul, and a chance for a Broncos three-point play.
Again, the fouls back-to-back. These Knights really need to learn to just play smart. If they keep giving up points like this, it's going to be a close game.
You see it. And the shot, and it is good, and that is a Broncos three-point play converted by C.J. Angulis. And we are tied at 6 apiece. Oh, a nice cut to the basket by Davis. The pass led him a little too far, and it's out of bounds. But some nice help defense coming over from the weak side to create that turnover.
You can tell these Knights are willing to be physical if it means getting to that ball.
Broncos have turned it over a couple of times here against this press. Drive, Agulis, a step back jumper, and he knocks it down. CJ one more time. It's 8-6, Northgate.
The Knights' zone defense is just showing a lot of holes right now. They need to tighten that up in order to stop CJ, especially from getting these points in.
Wood going on the baseline, puts it up, can't get the roll. And Agulis cleans up the rebound. Here comes CJ bringing it up the floor for Northgate. He's made two baskets in a row. Drive to the baseline, kicked it out. There's the shot, and he knocks it down. Daniel Louie from downtown again, 11-6.
Surprising. You'd think Jake Davis would be the star right now, but Northgate's offense is showing that they're the three-point master in this gym right now.
And we got a foul here on the floor. That's going to go against the Bronco defense. I think that's going to be team foul number 2 against Northgate. Now, when they go down in the corner to our right, the student body is all standing up, though. So Brooke and I are going to lose the basketball when it goes down in the corner.
You can't beat that intense rivalry the Creek has down here. And if we lose that clock, oh, well.
Non-shooting foul, so the Knights will inbound from the baseline. Shot and a foul, and a chance now for a Knights three-point play. Matt Fritchie, I hope I'm saying that right.
Fritchie, yes.
Fritchie, and he'll have a chance for a three-point play. So one on the Broncos side. Let's see now if the Knights can complete theirs. So for Northgate, coming in at 4-10 overall, an 0-1 in conference. And that one is no good. So they do not get the three-point play. 11-8 is our score. Northgate with the ball and the lead. Trapped on the baseline. Louie's got it from the elbow. Dribble drive. Here comes that defense from that zone press. And then up and over and counted in a chance for a three-point play. Angulis again, and he has had a wonderful start to the evening.
That was an excellent, beautifully executed play. He's clearly showing that he knows how to maneuver that ball, even with two men on top of him. The Northgate Broncos clearly understand how to play under pressure and with coverage on top of them. The way to play that layup is really well.
Foul shot won't go. 13-8 in favor of the visiting Northgate Broncos right now, and here come the Knights. Knights have substituted a couple of times, got some fresh bodies in there. Oh, baseline pass is good. The turnaround shot wasn't good there for Jake Bowen.
Sophomore Will Jones really handled that ball correctly, you know, just seeing all that.
Oh, and this one off the rim and the backboard and counted from downtown. And that is Jake Andujas. And he knocks down the shot. And it's 16-8 right now as the Broncos have doubled up the Knights. And now we have a foul reaching. And it looked like they're going to get Louie over the back.
Surprising to see the Knights just not dominating right now, considering the strength they've had in their schedule and their ability to play as a team. I mean, the coach Ezra Hunter, I mean, seriously highlighted on the fact that they are a team and they're willing to work together and put together in all this effort, yet it doesn't seem like they're connecting at the moment with that ball.
Well, Jake Davis connects right there with the follow-away shot from the elbow, and that makes it 16-10, 2:40 and counting in a very fast pace. First quarter.
I spoke too soon.
Well, sooner or later, as Davis knocks this one away, sooner or later, the stars are going to shine.
Yes.
Inbound here for the Broncos.
Zone
drive. Nice spin against the double team. Count it, and a foul, and another chance for a Bronco three-point play.
Against some of the tallest players right now, and somehow they're still putting in every single point.
Jake Andujas, number 11, the point guard slash shooting guard, and boy, a beautiful spin move right into the teeth of the defense. The double team was there, but they still couldn't stop him, and he makes the foul shot and completes another Bronco three-point play.
It is just truly surprising after seeing last week how well they were able to execute and put that ball in the hoop. And right now, it is just a struggle.
Davis drives, finishes, draws the foul, and on the other side, a chance for a Knights three-point play.
It's what they need right now, especially down 5 points. Anything goes. Seven, sorry.
Jake Davis, the 6'4 senior, one of the best players in the league, 26 points in that game against Okolonis, and his foul shot completes a three-point play. And with 2:14 to go in the opening period, 19-13 in favor of the visiting Broncos.
Almost a steal.
Drive to the corner. Jump shot is good, and that's a three-point shot. Knocked down by number 20, Charlie Walters. He barely missed a shot earlier in the ball game, but he was point blank on that one.
Wow. Their ability to score right now is just impressive.
Davis shot off the front of the iron, no good. Ball tipped around, taken by Northgate, runs into a crowd, taken away by the Knights. Then Northgate got it back, and they're going to say somebody kicked the ball. Who are they going to award the ball? He said it was a kick ball, but he didn't actually say who it was. But it looks like the Knights are going to get it. So kicked by the Broncos. So the Knights are going to get it here. Down by 9, the biggest lead of the ball game here so far for Northgate.
These fouls are being their saviors right now, but they need to be able to put some points in the hoop by themselves in order to take the lead back.
A little bit of a weave. 2-3 zone here again for Northgate, trying to keep everything on the outside. And underneath, and this one has to be saved, but not in time. Giving it his best effort was Matt Freechy, but he could not save it on the baseline. This time the Broncos handle that zone pretty easily. Ooh. Trying to get to the inside. Bumped hard, no foul call. Here come the Broncos in transition. Out into the corner, that's a three-point shot. Knocked it down! Knocking it down, Hudson Douglas, number 5. He gets his first basket of the game, 22-16. Broncos coming back into the teeth of the defense, draws a foul, and Northgate will go to the free throw line.
That three-point play was set up all by senior Nathan Ballesteri, number 44. Actually, he did play offensive and defensive lineman for the Las Lomas Knights football team, showing that he has incredible balance and he's not afraid to take a man down if needed.
Couple of shots for Grayson Boosted. First shot is good. The foul, Nate Ballesteri, called for it. Five team fouls for the Broncos. Five team fouls now so far for Las Lomas.
Michael Wood has re-entered the game for Nathan Ballesteri.
Yes. And we've got a timeout on the floor. No? Are they going to call timeout? No, they didn't. I thought they did, but here come the Knights with the basketball. Under a minute to go here, and now they're going to have them retake it out.
A lot of whistles.
Something had to be settled, but apparently it is now when we are ready to resume. 24-16, under a minute to go here in the first period. Anthony Schultz and Brooke Kilgore here on Walnut Creek TV, where TV comes home from the baseline. The shot won't go, but a foul is called. And going back to the line is the Las Lomas Knights.
Back up is senior Jack Halpin, who has played on the team for the past 4 years and has proved himself to be a pretty consistent and reliable player, although pressure may get to him. We'll see how this goes.
First shot for Halpin, and that rims in. Count that one for Jack. Jack Halpin, 6'5", lefty, also plays lacrosse. Very athletic guy, fast and can handle the ball. And if you're a lacrosse player, you figure you can run.
Endurance is key in this game,
absolutely.
I know for a fact.
So it lasts several possessions here, Brooke. The Broncos have not had much of a problem with that press. They break it pretty easily here.
They're small but mighty. Their height is not an issue, clearly, here. They're easily playing against our 6'8 middle. You know, all of these plays are made just because they're making the right moves at the right times.
Halpin going all the way, hits the ground, draws the foul, and Jack will go back to the free throw line. 28 seconds to go, trying to cut into a 6-point lead. They're going to say non-shooting here. Boy, I was surprised to see that. And Davis wheels around inside and can't hit the bunny. Oh, he made a great move. Mike Wood back up with it. Can't get it to go. Boy, shades of what happened in the Akalanis game a couple of nights ago, but they get the steal. Back they come. Off the glass, no good. Wood's got it underneath. Puts it off the glass and home.
After 4 to 5 attempts there, you'd think at some point they'd make that ball in.
Boy, good hustle. And the last shot of the first quarter, no good. And the first quarter ends with a score. The Broncos 24, Knights 20. Stay tuned. We'll be back with second quarter action from Las Lomas. All right, ready to resume the start of the second quarter. A fresh 8 minutes on that second quarter clock. And after falling down by as many as 9, the Knights have stormed back. They trail by 4 as we start the next period. Ball tipped and knocked away. This is going to be out of bounds. And last touch by the Broncos, and the Knights will have it. So
it is truly surprising to see their failure to put that 5-attempt layup streak in. I mean, we saw it last week, but I didn't think they – I think it would be a big, huge, like a huge thing to work on at practice, and it's just insane to see that they've missed it that many times. That's probably the biggest issue of tonight.
Davis missing. Halpin going for the rebound, knocked it out of bounds. And here come the Broncos with it, leading by 4, their first possession of the second period. And this one passes, is intercepted. And how about that? The press works again. Here's a long 3-point shot, knocked it down. Hudson Douglas from downtown. It's a 1-point ball game.
Quick comeback really turns it around for the Knights here.
Oh, beautiful pass to the inside. The shot's no good, but a foul call. And the Bronco faithful, or pardon me, the Knights faithful doesn't like it very much, but the Broncos going back to the free throw line.
The crowd is loud in here, you can tell.
Charlie Walters barely missed that shot, but he was fouled. He misses the first free throw, however.
You can tell this Los Lomas crowd is geared up and ready to yell. They are trying to throw number Brady Foster off as he makes his foul attempt.
Oh, I'm sorry, I had the wrong number. Yeah, Brady Foster missing both of them. I thought it was number 20. Tough to see that number from the side, but it wasn't Walters, excuse me. But both foul shots missed. 1 point game with a floater and count it. Hudson Douglas with a couple in a row. He hits one from downtown. This time he gets inside and hits the floater.
He is truly standing out right now as the team's top attempter and even pushing himself in there and attempting those three-pointers. It's amazing to see.
Oh, pass to the outside. Floater won't go. So they passed up the free throw line jumper to try to get something in closer. He couldn't get it to go. Halpin all the way and scores with the left hand.
Halpin has found his rhythm.
Timeout on the floor. 6:33 to go here in the second quarter. The Knights have reclaimed a 27-24 lead.
It's amazing what a simple timeout and break in the quarter can do to a team.
And Hudson Douglas hitting from the outside, hitting from the inside, and some of that defense didn't hurt either. And it's a three-point lead as we head to this timeout.
Clearly, these three-point difference have clearly brought out some enthusiasm in the Knights crowd right now, already starting their taunts towards the Northgate bench.
First home game for Las Lomas, and it's the coaches versus cancer ball game. So every three-point shot, the coaches will donate $25, and for every dunk, they'll donate $100. So with the three-point shots going down, they're going to have to pony up some, and that's for both teams.
I know,
so
seriously.
That could get quite expensive, but it's obviously for a good cause. All right, Broncos going to face that press. Sly Hunter told me earlier in the week that they're going to press coming off the bus with this team. Now, can you do it for a whole game and keep that endurance? That's always a question. Ball knocked away. Last touch. Actually, it's going to be a tie-up, and let's see who had the possession arrow.
That ball cannot get past Michael Wood's long arm span, clearly.
Possession arrow with the Broncos, so they'll keep the basketball. Looking to tie or cut it to one here on this possession.
Quick movement. The Broncos are trying to break through that zone defense, trying to find another hole.
You know, considering, this ball almost lost on the sideline, recovered nicely.
Great movement by Jake Andus.
And this one's going to go out of bounds. Yeah, Andus really did a nice job, almost lost it. Recovered nicely and actually had somebody open on the wing there for an open shot, but didn't see him. Dribble drive, baseline, off the backboard, no good. Rebound. And boy, this is going to be a turnover here. That is going to be was that a shot clock violation?
I believe so. The buzzer went off, so yeah, I assume so.
But I thought they had 24 seconds. It seemed like that was a quick clock.
Sense of time passes quickly in high school basketball.
Seconds move faster for some reason.
I can't believe it's already the second quarter.
5:51 to go, 27-24, and a seesaw affair. Right now the Broncos with the lead, and Davis going to be fouled trying to go inside. He was not attempting a shot, but they are getting very close now to bonus time. Both teams with six fouls, and was that number seven? It was. So Jake Davis going to get a chance to shoot free throws and work on this three-point lead.
The Knights can get that bonus play. Maybe it will be the key to taking the lead over the, or continuing to take over the lead over the Northgate Broncos. Maybe that foul will come back to help them.
First shot, and that one is good. That was a one-and-one situation. Had to get the first to get the second, and he did. Jake Davis talked about that 26 points against Akalanis the other night, and that was actually an off night for him when he really struggled to hit a free throws. He's gotten JC offers, Division II offers, but they think that when it's all said and done, he'll have a chance to play at the Division I level. That kind of special of a player.
Jake Davis is the highest scoring player on this team right now, around 250 points in total, 18 points per game. I mean, it's just insane to watch him play.
And there's the steal and the dunk. And there's our first
$100.
There's our first $100. donation there provided by Jake Davis. What a play. It's 31-24.
Thank Broncos you, Jake Davis.
Pass it back. And just with it on the corner. Davis recovers quickly on defense. Now inside, ball lost on the baseline. Saved by, no, tried to save it, was Wood, but he could not do it on the baseline, and it's going to be on the baseline, inbounding here for the Broncos.
Those quick quarterback feet couldn't keep him in bounds long enough.
Tough with the inbound here. Finally getting over, but he can't get it over Mike Wood, but Mike lost it on the sideline. Mike Wood, 6'7". One of the fastest guys on the team. They sort of say they needs to get into hoop shape, and that's kind of funny talking about football players, but different sports kind of, you know, use different muscles and a lot more, maybe a lot more sprinting here in basketball.
I think you're just used to people tackling you all the time, so those fouls are more prone to happen once you're in your defensive stance, but he's getting his legs back, you can tell.
And they say he will get tired from time to time because they do all that pressing, and that's when he usually gets into foul trouble, so they'll try to avoid that. Nice dribble into the paint, off the backboard a little too strong. Offensive rebound blocked.
Great block. I believe that was number 10, Colin Pangulin.
Now, Grayson Boosted made a nice move to get into the paint. He's a little strong with the shot. And then the follow-up was blocked by good interior defense from Las Lomas. Here's the inbound. Tough to get it over Mike Wood. They do. That's a whole lot of length to get it over when he stretches out that arm.
Very much so. Imagine his vertical, too.
This is the biggest lead of the ball game for Northgate. Nice pass to the outside of the apex of the arc. But Halpin adjusted nicely on defense, recovered very well. There's to the outside, to the elbow, to the outside, looking for that three-point shot, not there, and trying to go up against Wood, and Wood's having none of it. Boy, that wasn't even close to getting over him that time.
He read that ball incredibly well, and he just knew to put his arms up and hope that he would just throw it right into him, and that's exactly what happened, Tony.
Joey Suen into the ball game now for Northgate. Here's a three-point shot. Back of the iron, no good as the horn sounds for the shot clock. They get it off in time, but they don't get the shot. 4:27 and counting, 31-24. Broncos, there's one put up. No good. Halpin the follow. Can't get it. Woods got it. And he wisely brings it back out. Long shot for Douglas off the rim and no good.
That layup offense is what needs to happen right now. Good that they got that ball out, but it still shows that they couldn't put that ball in.
This one's going to go out of bounds here in the backcourt. And last touch by the Knights. And this will come over to Northgate. They're going to have it in the front court here. 7-point lead for Northgate. They trailed by as many as 9.
Amazing how quickly that turned over.
Suen gets a high screen on top. Little give and go here. And the shot off the back iron and up into the basket stanchion. No good, and the score remains 31-24.
Mike is coming out off the bench, and in comes Drew Guzulski, one of the starters at the beginning of the game.
Colin Pangulin is into the ball game now, and a blocked shot on the baseline. Recovered by the Knights, and he scores! Darion Marabotti making that shot after the shot was blocked. So offensive rebound and a putback for the Knights. They extend the lead now. They lead it by 9, their biggest lead of the game. Into the corner it goes. Dribble drive into the teeth of that zone defense. Tried to get on the baseline, knocked away by Douglas and recovered by Darian. Halpin all the way, draws the foul, and he'll go back to the free throw line. And boy, that's like the third time tonight that Halpin has worked his way to the stripe.
He really knows how to play this Northgate defense and put it to his advantage. It's amazing to see how well he's executing that. The crowd understands what's at stake, too.
Pair of shots here for Halpin. Lefty shot and just does trickle out.
Davis and Jones ran her the game.
Mike Shaughnessy, head coach here at Northgate. Been here for a couple of years. Among those was the COVID season. So after seeing all his starters graduate last year, second shot is good. Really trying to sort of get back into the flow of things, and it's been a tough start here to the 22-23 campaign for the Broncos, who were very successful last year.
It's strange to see a team that was so strong defensively just struggle in this, you know, league season right now. Same could be said for Los Lomas after switching to their third coach in the past 4 years.
Yeah, that can never be easy, especially when you figure the guys coming up from freshman to JV to varsity know the system when they get there, and that's just not the way things are working out right now. Here's a shot put up and counted. That is, and just hits his another shot for him, and the score 34-26. Dribble drive into the paint. Here comes the defense. Turnaround, fall away, knocked down. Whoa, what a shot. Will Jones creating for himself and finding his own space and making the shot. Very well done.
He's been quick on his feet tonight, and it's just really shown he knows where that ball's going and how to play it efficiently, and it's amazing to see.
Angus running the point. Davis eyeball to eyeball with him. Here comes a high screen, trying to look for that give and go, and then we get the foul. You set the screen, you move to one side, and you got to get that ball immediately to the screener to give him an opportunity, but the Knights fouled anyway.
Northgate really needs this opportunity to make sure that they can pull the lead back before halftime.
So here's Angus now as the... Everybody's into the bonus right now, so Angus going to get a chance to shoot foul shots. Needs the first one here, and he gets it.
Keeping a very calm and collected manner. Hopes that he can put in the next one.
And the second one is good. 36-28, 2:18 to go here in the half.
Northgate has just really shown that any free throws they get, they will try at 100% to put them in, and they know they can.
Shot from way downtown, a three-point shot, and it's Zane Mojahedini.
Hope I got that one right.
What a shot. Boy, he was like three steps behind the arc that time. 39-28. Dribble drive into the paint. Here comes the defense. Baseline Ooh. Pass. And we're going to have a foul.
Jake Davis threw himself at him. Amazing he stayed upright.
So getting fouled that time was Landon Johnson. But we've seen so many times here tonight, Brooke, that dribble penetration into the paint is going to draw a crowd. Somebody's going to be open, and they had the open man on the baseline. Johnson shot, and this one hits just the net.
Just too short.
And boy, the crowd's really giving it to him.
The sixth man is here for both teams tonight.
Second one, no.
Northgate's going to feel that one soon.
Boy, yeah. Down by 11, two shots and you miss them both. That's got to hurt. Double team.
Ooh.
Mojahedini. And then Jake knocks down the three. And here come the Knights starting to run away here a little bit. 42-28. Northgate needs a basket in the worst way here. Last minute, 20 seconds of the half. Dribble drive, nice spin, floater counting. Boy, beautiful. Jake Angus, exactly what they needed. And boy, almost getting all the way to the cup, working against a zone defense, very difficult to do. Here's Davis.
Northgate's defense is well coordinated. Their zone coverage is ready for him.
And that shot from the outside. Mojahedini can't get that one. And this one is going to be out of bounds. Last touched by the Knights, and the Broncos have it. 56 ticks to go.
Northgate has shown they can do anything they set their minds to, so these 56 seconds could be very pivotal for them in their offense.
Jake Hand just made that last tough shot. Let's see if Northgate can come back with another one. Dribbling, looking for some room. Gets it back to Hand. Just Jake wants a long three-point shot off the rim. No good.
Just short.
Jake Hanges, junior, second year on varsity. He's really improved a lot, and we see that, especially with his ball handling. They call him a knockdown shooter. Not that time, however. Boy, good book, and behind the back, we lose the ball a little bit. Mojahedini, dribble drive, bumps in to Louie, and back out for Jake. Jake against Jake on the outside. Mojahedini into the corner.
And now we're going to have a traveling call. Just picked up the ball a little bit too early with Gozaleski. And boy, in the NBA, a lot of times they'll let you get away with that, but not at the high school level. Very touchy with those traveling calls.
These small little fouls are mostly being caused because Northgate's defense is on top of the Knights right now. Anywhere they move, there's a defender in their face, and it's making them choose harder decisions than they normally would.
Hanges got it off the glass and home at the buzzer. And that's the way the first half ends. Northgate, a huge comeback. They trailed going into the second quarter by 4. They lead it by 10. We are at halftime from Walnut Creek, and we'll be back with the second half action right here on Walnut Creek TV. Thank you.
32 in favor of the Knights. And here we go, Jake Davis running the point for Las Lomas.
Davis with it, dribble drive, double team, puts up the floater, off the glass and home. And Jake Davis, the star, starting to shine.
Truly coming strong out like that in the first couple seconds. That's what a team needs in order to succeed in the second half.
Here come the Broncos across the timeline, trailing now by 12. Had a four-point lead at the end of one. Now find themselves down by double digits. First shot doesn't go. Sly Hunter, the head coach for this team. Three coaches in 4 years, we told you about that. In his first year here with Las Lomas. And the pass nearly lost. Back over to Mike Wood. He wants the corner three. Eight ball corner pocket for Mike Wood. A three-pointer, 47-32. And now the lead balloons to 15.
That's his first one of the game, I believe. And it's just amazing to see centers go out and make huge plays like that.
Stolen by Davis. Finishes and a foul. And now a chance for a Knights three-point play.
Wow. This Knights offense is completely different than the one we saw in the first half. Some locker room talk must have happened because they are a whole new team.
There's Jake Davis trying to complete the three-point play. Sly Hunter played at St. Mary's, graduated in 88, coached at DVC as well. Also, believe it or not, played football at St. Mary's, for those of you who can remember that. And Davis knocks down the shot, and he completes the Knights' three-point play, and the lead all of a sudden 50-32.
Football at St. Mary's, wow, I'm young. I only know rugby, so.
I don't remember football at St. Mary's. Northgate needs a run, and they need it in a big way. Trailing now by 18. Dribble drive into the paint and kicks it out, and now we're going to have a Knights foul. And it's going to be inbound from the baseline for the Broncos. On that football team for Sly Hunter, they actually went 10-0. I think he told me he was the last guy at St. Mary's to play both basketball and football before the football program went defunct.
Amazing. Dual athletes are some of the strongest people I think I've ever seen. We have a lot of them on our team here.
Stolen away. Fast break. Slam dunk. There's another 100.
$200. He hopped that like a bunny rabbit.
Julian Boucher with the steal and the slam. And boy, this one is turning into a rout here. 6:13 to go. It's a 20-point night lead.
I need his jumping routine. I wish I had a vertical like that.
Into the paint, fade away, off the glass and home and count it, and a chance for a Bronco three-point play. Boy, that was a pretty move going against the big guy, Mike Wood.
It seems even though Northgate is down by so much, they're answering every single time, and that will eventually, hopefully, turn over for them.
C.J. Agulis makes that play over Mike Wood, making it 52-34. Can he complete the three-point play? Yes, he can. Nothing but the bottom of the cylinder. 52-35. Now, still a ton of time to go, but the Broncos have really got to get this thing turned around before they get blown out of the building. Long three-point shot, knocked it down from way downtown. Julian Boucher, back-to-back baskets. Stolen. Davis had it, lost it.
Ooh.
Broncos have it back. Here they come,
back.
Three on one. Battle against Wood, and a foul.
That was almost back in Knight territory, but luckily the Broncos brought it back just in time.
I think you might have wanted to say something about the delicious dinner that we had earlier
tonight.
Oh,
my goodness. Thank you to the Las Lomas team moms for putting that on for us. That was amazing. I'm so happy I didn't eat before this.
Salad, white sauce pasta, red sauce pasta. And I love it when they don't forget the French bread.
Oh, the garlic bread is the best part of those meals.
First shot off the rim, no good. So the Broncos, here's another thing you talk about that's important. It sometimes gets overlooked. Simple things like foul shooting. The Broncos, we've seen them miss a few here. And when you're trailing by this much, you can't afford to give anything away.
We also discussed how Las Lomas, the fouls were what killed them in their last week's game. And this game tonight, I feel like they've put that to their use and have scored so many more points off of it than they earned last week.
Boucher, the nice pass on the baseline. He picks up the assist, getting the ball out to Drew Gozaleski. And boy, Boucher all of a sudden the last few trips, making his presence felt.
Truly amazing to see players come out and just start to shine in the most needed moments.
Dribble drive inside, and this pass is going to be blocked, taken away. Oh, what a beautiful play defensively by Halpin. trying to go all the way. Left hand off the glass and home.
Amazing
Mike Halpin
steal.
Defensively and then in transition.
Mm-hmm. The ability to steal that ball and bring it back and do something with it is always key.
Now talk about doing it on both ends of the floor. Here's a three-point shot off the rim, off the backboard, no good. And there's Halpin again. He's playing really well tonight. Euro step, can't finish. Follow, no good. Fast break
on that basket.
And off the glass and home for Northgate. Agulis gets the basket, 59-38. But I think the Knights want to call timeout. They see kind of their momentum slipping a little bit. But with 4:30 to go right now, it is a big lead for the home team.
They may also want to give their starter, Jack Halpin, a bit of a break. He's been hustling up and down that court, stealing balls left and right. Just gather, regroup, and make sure your team's all on the same page before coming back on.
Yeah, using that tempo and pressing a lot, it takes a lot of endurance, and sometimes you can do it for a while, but can you keep doing it? Mike Wood coming from football, the quarterback, as we said, you know, he was not with the team during conditioning, and the guys that weren't here still trying to sort of, you know, get their basketball legs, but so far so good, I'd say, for Las Lomas.
I think so. Truly, I mean, athletes who can play these dual sports are really taking on a giant commitment. The ability to transition into different types of sports and take on the needs, physical needs, that each sport requires, it's just truly amazing to see what these student athletes can do.
No, and these aren't the kind of sports that, I mean, it's just fun to play and you go to practice. You're playing football, especially, and basketball. These are real commitments because you just can't be in halfway good shape to play these sports.
Seriously.
All right, here's Boucher. I thought Davis was going to give it to him, but he didn't. Boucher trying to get open in that corner. Here's Boucher. He's got it.
There he is.
Davis on top. Halpin, the lefty jumper, won't go from the baseline. The lead is 21. Mark this down at 4:05 to go. Northgate trails by 21. Into the paint, off the glass at home with the windmill shot. Oh, that was a beautiful move and a pretty finish for Northgate's C.J. Agulis.
He's been a real showstopper tonight, and it's just amazing to see how he takes that ball and executes every play.
Boy, what a move and shot. That was really pretty by Will Jones. He couldn't get the finish, though. There's one off the glass at home, and now a chance for a Northgate three-point play.
Wow.
They cut the lead to 19. Chance to cut it even further with 3:36 to go here in the third.
This team is doing an incredibly great job at picking up those rebounds off the Knights' failed layup attempts and making something with it. This is something they need in order to bring back that lead that they once had in the first quarter.
Here's Daniel Louis now from the free throw line. He's the De La Salle transfer, and this one won't go. De La Salle transfer had to sit out the first seven games because of that transfer rule. But getting into the swing of things, and had a good first quarter for the Broncos. Halpin off the glass, won't get it.
There
gets his own miss and puts it back. Now it looks like there's a wet spot on the floor they're going to deal with there.
Call the towel team.
So Louis is another good shooter on this team. They tell me he could improve his defense a little bit, but he stepped up when he's had to. And he will guard some of the better players on the opposing team, and he stepped up in that fashion, and he's really starting to find his rhythm. Swarming defense here by the Knights. Agulis looking for some room, and he draws the foul. This will be a non-shooting foul, and the Broncos will inbound on the baseline. Boy, that is the fifth team foul already against Las Lomas.
Wow.
So in this late going here, we might see a parade to the free throw line for the Broncos. But if that happens, can they take advantage of it?
Seeing how Las Lomas easily turned that around with just free throws, I'm sure the Broncos can come back and take that lead easily.
Three-point shot, and that one is knocked down. And Northgate creeps a little bit closer. Jake Andrews hits the shot again. On the baseline, body bumping, and then we're going to call an offensive foul. Going back the other way.
There's your lineman stance right there. He threw him to the ground with no remorse. That is the sign of a very, very tough offensive player.
Here come the Broncos now, trailing by 16. Still 2:28 to go here in the third quarter. Long time to go in this basketball game. To the outside, there's a three-point shot, and that one hits the side of the rim, no good. Defensive rebound nearly stolen away.
Will Jones did a great job picking that ball up after it fell off the feet of Nathan Ballesteri.
Davis, Halpin, and we're going to have a blocking foul. And that looked like it was deep into the painted area. The Broncos probably not very happy with that call, but it's going to be a foul against the Broncos. And the Knights will have it, and they'll inbound on the baseline. Will Jones to key it in with 2:09 to go here in the third. The Broncos, since the end of that first quarter, have really kind of fallen behind here as we've seen the Knights dominate. Here's near steal, and this one's going to be out of bounds. Last touched by the Broncos, and the Knights will keep it.
Funny how fast the tides have turned in this game. Truly amazing.
Yeah, 24-20 at the end of one, 42-32 in favor of the Knights at the end of two.
Northgate's Grayson Bosted just went in.
Oh, there's a nice pass to Jake, cutting to the basket, and he lays it home. Davis, they just forgot about him on the perimeter, and he snuck right in at the defense, right behind the defense.
Could have gotten us our third dunk of the night there.
Into the corner, we lose it there. Swinging around back on top, Louie looking to make a move. Into the corner, there's a shot, let's fly off the rim, no good. And Will Jones will track it down on the baseline. Douglas has got it. He wants the shot, and off the rim, no good. Halpin gets it.
Davis. Defense.
Double team came quickly. Outside, Douglas wants the three-point shot, and he knocks it down. Boy, he's been deadly from outside.
Hudson Douglas has been that shining star of the Las Lomas offense tonight, putting up so many points and just so unexpectedly.
Boy, air ball from the outside. Not the answer the Broncos were looking for. And now they trailed by 21, and listen to the crowd.
Oh, my goodness.
Boy, they let you have it for the air ball, don't they?
They really do. No mistake goes unnoticed.
The lead is 21. Minute 15 to go here in the third. And really, ever since the end of that first quarter, the Knights have absolutely dominated Northgate. Dribble drive to the inside. Douglas wants a three, and he got the three. Back-to-back shots from downtown by Douglas, and the lead balloons to 24.
The coaches' wallets are going to be hurting tonight after all these three-pointers.
Boy, nice pass to the outside. There's a three-point shot off the rim, no good. Offensive rebound, however, for Northgate, and the Broncos get another chance. Last 40 seconds of the third. Broncos need a run in the worst way here.
Oh, there it is.
Davis blocked it. It goes out of bounds. He touched it last, and I think the Broncos are going to keep it. 31 seconds to go in the third.
It seems like the roles have switched. The once prominent Northgate defense is now struggling to compete with the Las Lomas defense, who is all in their face and forcing them to make those hard and tough decisions.
Yeah, nothing's coming easy for the Bronco offense. So when they do get open, Brooke, they've got to hit those shots. Boy, there's a hard body bump right there.
Nathan Ballesteri is a wall, and these Northgate Broncos keep falling into it.
Yeah, and when that guy hits you, you're going to stay hit.
Yeah, you're going down regardless. Saw him take out 6'8 Jake Davis of Akilani's the other night. Put him flat on his butt.
Bustad here to shoot foul shots. First one, no good, and there we go again. Now, I know it's a long way to come back down by 24, but you can't afford to miss those foul shots like that.
Northgate can't give up anything else right now if they still want a chance to take the Creek home.
Next shot.
Good.
Mike Shaughnessy and Northgate winning both matchups against the crosstown rival last year. Here's one loose. Jake Davis lost it. Broncos have it. Now we're going to have a jump ball situation. And possession arrow, I believe, favors Northgate, so they'll get the basketball.
I don't remember basketball ever being this physical on TV, but I see guys flying at each other nowadays. This looks like tackle football.
Yeah, they used to say about basketball that it was not a contact sport. I say until you play it.
Yeah.
5 seconds to go here in the third. Another quarter dominated by the Broncos. Now we got a foul here, And the Broncos back to the free throw line, 1-1 situation here for Angus. And Jake needs the first to get the second. 18 fouls now against the Knights. Yes. Angus has had himself a nice game. Mike Shaughnessy, coaching at Northgate since 2020. Last year was his first full season. They went 20-9 last year. And the guys that had been the program 4 years, that was the first 20-win season they had had. 2 seconds, 1 second, ball loose, and that's the way the third quarter will end. So after three quarters of play here from Walnut Creek, it's the Knights 69, Broncos 48. Come on back. Fourth quarter coming up right here on Walnut Creek TV.
All right, pal.
Hey, Dad. Do we have a gun?
What's that?
Do we have a gun?
Why do you ask that, kiddo?
Can I play with it?
No, absolutely not. It's not a toy. You know that. Anyway, I need it to protect you, your sister, and Mom.
But what about the 8 kids who get shot every day by mistake?
Where'd you hear that?
Where do you keep it?
It's hidden.
I bet it's on top shelf of the closet, under your sweatshirts. Is it loaded? Remember when I found my Christmas gifts? You always told me to be curious.
No. No, that's not what I meant.
And when it's just me and Mom, I could use the gun to protect her.
No, Justin, I promise. I'm always here for you.
But Dad, you're not always here.
All righty. Las Lomas would like to announce that they are opening their snack shack for donations in the Coaches Against Cancer game. Any donations are accepted, and half of them will be going to charity in order to support families out there who need it most.
Always a very nice gesture. Charity is always very appreciated, especially when it gets into the right hands.
Yes, it does. Several sports have taken on donations and fundraisers like this. Las Lomas Volleyball I played for this season, and we did our Dig Pink game for breast cancer awareness, and that was a huge hit. So it's always nice to see other sports step up and take on causes like this.
Yeah, and even in the professional ranks, you see the pink bats and the pink cleats in football, and
especially
everybody's really, like, you know, getting into the act with that. It's nice to see.
Yes, it is.
All right, fourth quarter action. A long way to go for the comeback here for Northgate as they trail 69-48, the lead 21. Halpin outside. There's the three-point shot knocked down. And boy, Las Lomas is pouring it on. Moja Hadidi knocks down a three. He's had a couple of those tonight.
He has just stepped up as a player who we've seen kind of off to the side a lot of the game, but it's clearly been his show tonight.
Yeah, ball lost there in a backcourt violation for Northgate. And right now, unfortunately for the boys in black, they are getting routed here in the crosstown game.
This Knight six man is also beating down on them too.
Boy, Douglas misses badly right there. Here's the Broncos trying to hurry this one up. And if nothing else, Brooke, put a little cosmetic surgery onto this fourth quarter.
They need something to help them right now if they're ever going to have a chance of rallying against this Las Lomas defense.
Oh, boy, ooh. There is a body bump. Nasty. Collision. Right there. And they're always going to get the defender on that one. So a foul going against Las Lomas. And they are going to get Julian Avouche, who's made his presence felt here tonight. He had a couple of nice series in this ball game. He commits the foul here, and the Broncos going to the line. It's Boosted.
Las Lomas has given Northgate the advantage of a bonus round in this area right now, meaning they get their free throws every foul.
And that one put up and counted.
7 minutes may not seem like a lot of time, but if they move fast and they play well, they could easily come back against the Knights.
And the shot is good. He gets them both for Boosted. 70-52, but still a whole long way to come back. Long three-point shot.
Wow.
Moja Hadidi again.
Wow.
And now we've got a technical foul call.
Even before the foul, he was at least 5 steps away from that three-point line. That's an amazing range for him tonight.
Did they call a technical foul? They did.
Wow.
That'll go against the Knights. The three-point shot for Moja Hadidi counts. and it's 75-50. Technical foul shot and made for the Broncos, and they're going to get one more here.
Moadidi is only a sophomore, meaning he has two more years with this Knights offense and defense. If he keeps putting in points like these, he is sure going to be a household name for the Las Lomas community for years to come.
So Las Lomas, they tell me their style of defense is to try to funnel everything away from the middle. And the Broncos have taken some shots there, but really I think it's the biggest change in the game has been the outside shooting of Las Lomas that has been absolutely deadly, and the Broncos have just not been able to keep up. This one put up off the glass, no good. They scramble around for it. And we're going to have a Bronco foul, and the Knights are going to get the basketball.
This defense is holding their own against the Northgate Broncos right now. The tides have clearly turned. Las Lomas in its home gym is showing these Broncos who's the dominant force, offense and defense alike.
So here are the Broncos playing some full court defense, trying to speed this one up. Ooh. But a pass to the outside, Halpin off the glass and home.
Amazing.
And when you stretch out your defense like that, sometimes you get burned, and that time the Broncos did. So here's that Las Lomas defense we were talking about, trying to funnel everything away from the middle of the floor, force things to the outside. They do it right there, but the shot is buried. Nicely done there by Angus, who hits it from downtown. 77-55, 6:09 to go in the ball game.
Ooh.
Now we're going to have a drive in, and now we're going to have it. Looks like they're going to, did they call an offensive foul on that? They did call an offensive foul.
Took down two guys in the process, too. Impressive. These fouls are just coming in steadily at this rate.
Yeah, right there, they're determining that the defender was in position before the offensive player left his feet. Because if they don't do that, you have to give the offensive player a place to land. And boy, that was kind of a wild sequence right there.
Happy no one landed incorrectly.
So Northgate pouring it on here after the first quarter. The Knights pouring it on the Broncos here after that first quarter, which the Broncos had a 4-point lead. But ever since that time, it's been all Las Lomas here tonight. Drive to the inside, back outside. Here's a 3-point shot. Oh, knocked it down, and just again. You know, in what looks like it's going to be a losing effort. Boy, he's played well. Davis has it. Halpin has got it.
Ooh. Jeez. Didn't see that one coming.
And now, looked like, was that a timeout call? I think it was.
I believe so.
Timeout on the floor. 5:29 to go. The Knights 77 and the Broncos 58.
Even with these successful, inconsistent 3-point shots, the Broncos are struggling to put any points on the board right now. It's impressive that they've made 58 so far, considering the Knights' defense has just been all up at them and forcing them to make these quick decisions where they have to adjust or throw to someone else who wasn't ready for the ball. It's just strange to see how quickly that pace changed on them like that.
Well, it looked like it was a Northgate timeout. And for Las Lomas, several seniors on the team. And of course, but with all the coaching changes that we talked about earlier, Brooke, the players, haven't completely caught up to the system, but don't tell that to the Broncos. That's not going to make them feel good.
No, I don't think so.
So the Knights are going to be better than this later on in the season. That can't feel good for the rest of the DFAL.
I mean, considering Northgate was only down 10 points against defending title Camp Olindo, you can tell these Las Lomas Knights are going to put up something against other teams in their league.
Good battle for the rebound right there, taken by the Broncos. Dribble to the inside. Here comes the defense. Outside looking for that step back, but good recovery on the defense by the Knights. And here's one blocked away. Jake Davis Cohen saying, get out.
Can that be 50 points from the coaches? $50?
Yeah, Daniel Louie. And boy, it looked like Davis got up so high, he blocked it with his elbow. And this one taken by Douglas. On the rebound, looking for someone to get the ball to, and finally gets it out.
Ooh.
Dribble drive into the paint, tried to leave it for Halpin on the baseline, right through the wickets and out of bounds.
Didn't look like he was ready for that one. Mike Wood is back into the game in replacement for Matt Fritchie, I believe.
19-point lead for Las Lomas. And all the Broncos can really do is try to get shots up as quickly as possible. To the outside, saved on the baseline.
Double coverage.
Boy,
ooh.
D defense swarming. And Brooke, you were talking about the swarming defense earlier, and this time it forces the Broncos to take a timeout. 4:29 to go, 77-58 in favor of the home team Knights. There's the mascot getting a lot of camera time here.
Having a great time down there showing their Knights pride.
But of course, with all that gear on, completely anonymous.
I know. Wonder who it could be. Surprised there's no Northgate Bronco running around bucking people.
Last game for Las Lomas, they lost at Aquilanas. That was the 54-52 game. They had won three of their last five. Two of those wins coming against Tamalpais and Freedom. They're at Miramani on Wednesday. On Friday the 13th, they'll be here against Campo. That should be a very good game. On the 18th, they'll be here against Clayton Valley Charter.
As I stated before, Northgate was not that far off from beating Campo Lindo, only 10 points down. So if Las Lomas is proving dominant over these Northgate Broncos, what does that mean in terms of beating Campo Lindo?
Should be a wild season in the DFAL this year.
Of course it is.
Down inside, and shot no good, but we have a foul. And it looks like they're going to get Hudson Douglas on the foul, and C.J. Agulis will go to the free throw line. And first shot is good.
C.J. Agul has been a name we've said several times tonight, a senior for Northgate, just showing that he can get everywhere and anywhere and make these free-point throws just for his team.
Knocks this one down. Broncos putting on that press defense, looking for that turnover. They don't get it. Three on one going the other way. Off the glass, no good, but we have a Bronco foul.
Jake Davis is not happy about that one.
Yeah, TJ Agulis, he can score. He's got that good mid-range shot. We've seen that today. Mm-hmm. We've also seen him hit from a little further out as well. Long and lanky, good slasher. Guy who can get to the rim. And the guy that they like to see do that the battle on the post, getting rebounds and stuff, and hasn't been there so much tonight, but this is one that kind of got away from the Broncos after that first quarter.
Yeah. Just need to be able to hold on to that lead and keep it going. Any slip up in power or endurance and you're gone.
And the next one is good. Davis getting a pair of foul shots. The lead is 19 and 4:05 to go and counting here.
The Knights surprisingly do not have a bonus for them at the moment. Seems like they should after all of these fouls.
Broncos trying to get the ball inside. Nice switching defense there by the Ooh. Knights. Offensive rebound, put back no good, but a foul going to be called against Mike Wood.
Some and confusion there on the court.
Landon Silvera, the beneficiary, he'll go to the foul line. Northgate had come in actually playing pretty good basketball, Brooke. They'd won 3 of 4. And from December the 23rd through the 29th, they'd won 3 out of 4, wins over Vintage of Napa and Weston Ranch out of Stockton. So it wasn't like they came in struggling. Next shot, that is knocked down.
I believe it all depends on the environment and the mentality you come in with. If you think you're going to come in strong, you better be strong in your play. These Knights easily swept this away from them, and it's showing.
And the shot is good. 79-62. 3:48 to go. Knights in complete control in the Battle of the Creek right here on Walnut Creek TV.
Trying to run out the clock as fast as possible. Make them run for it.
Wood gets the basket and the assist from Halpin. And the Broncos have to extend the defense to try to get the turnovers. They can't sit back and just let the Knights run time off the clock. But this one has completely gotten away from the boys in black. Shot no good. Baseball pass.
Ooh, ref collision.
Jake's got it. Goes to the hole and lays it home off the glass.
As sad as it is to say for the Northgate defense. Oh!
Boy, the boys that time running toward that bench out here in front of the stands here right next to the scorer's table. And that looked like it could have been dangerous.
That, again, physicality in basketball is always so surprising.
I mean, crashing into a body is one thing, but
the stands?
The stands, that's the wood something stands. Else. They don't give much ground. Broncos scrambling around, trying to find some room. And the swarming Knight defense has been excellent tonight. There's a three-point shot knocked down. And that's Angus again. Talked about he's a good shooter, and he's shown that tonight. There's a shot no good. Broncos trying to collect the rebound, and they do. Angus bringing it across the timeline. And this pass on the baseline. Nice save there. Back to the outside, into the corner. Shot is up. It is no good. And we've got a foul underneath.
Northgate is just struggling to find options to pass to their teammates. I mean, like we said earlier, with the Knights offense or defense swarming all over
them,
there's the risk of a steal happening and them having to result to the same thing they did before. And it's just, it's starting to show in these last 3 minutes of the game that Northgate is struggling.
And here's the pass coming out to Davis. Nice off to Halpin. Off the glass, no good, but a foul. And we've talked about the Knights defense and the style that Coach Sly wants to play, you know, funneling everything to the outside and trying to take away that middle area. But it seems like every time the Broncos have the ball, two or three guys are right there with them.
Their only options are to shoot from the three-point line or try and run in a quick layup, and that's all they got right now.
And they just haven't found enough of the open floor in those situations where the Knights look like they've been able to press defense, be very close to them on defense, and then yet get out on the outside shooters quickly.
Northgate's offense and defense is starting to get run down. You can tell as half the court was still on the midline while Jack Halpin was running up for a layup.
And the score sometimes has a lot to do with that, unfortunately,
yes,
too.
Yes, morale is low. You can barely hear the Northgate crowd at the moment.
A 20-point Knights lead here, 85-65, last 2:13 to go. Dribble in to the free throw line. Ball knocked away. Going against two defenders there again. The shot won't go. And Douglas takes the rebound, but it looked like he went over the back. But there was an example of that defense. You see, they had a couple of guys on the ball when the shot was made. And then the other guys trying to get open when they get the ball. The recovery by the Knights defense has been excellent tonight.
I believe a Knights player is down. The athletic trainer is headed over.
Again, that's the corner that we cannot see.
Yeah, we have no idea what's going on right now.
So we've got a break in the action here. 2 minutes even to go. It's a 20-point lead for Las Lomas.
Oh, standing. Jack Halpin, senior. Sad to see him be hurt. He's been a pivotal point in this Knights offense tonight.
You know, and that's another thing you wonder about with a lead like this. If you're Coach Hunter, do you really want to keep some of these guys out here when this, let's face it, this game is over at this point?
Let the starters recover. They have a big couple games coming up Wednesday, Friday. Just at this point, let some of the other guys come in and make their start, make their plays. You can't risk injury in moments like these.
Yeah, and going to the NFL, the Los Angeles Chargers, a couple of guys hurt in a meaningless game as they're going to the playoffs. We don't want to see something like that with Las Lomas. Davis has got it. Davis off the glass and home.
Less than 2 minutes left in this game.
Yeah, Knights continue to pour it on. Last 1 minute 45 to go. To the inside, left-handed shot up off the back iron, no good.
That was a pivotal play. They needed that.
Body's banging in, going in. Ooh. Wood can't get the block. Follow is good.
Finally. Oh.
Well, the Broncos haven't quit. They're still trying to get every basket they can. And near a steal, and it goes out of bounds. It belongs to Las Lomas.
It's just surprising how much effort. I mean, we saw it with Las Lomas in the first quarter, layup after layup, and yet no point in. And just seeing it happen with Northgate now is just surprising.
Nice. Douglas again. Oh. Off the rim this time.
I'm noticing that they're struggling to get the ball past Michael Wood right now, or if he's still in. Yeah, he's all the way back here, but they're struggling against Las Lomas' height right now, especially as a shorter team.
Dunk.
Oh.
Not quite. He wanted to.
He wanted that $100. He wanted it.
And off the glass at home.
44 Broncos seconds tally. Left in the game. Maybe he'll get it again.
Reverse layup.
He tried. That's all that matters.
This one. And this one will go out of bounds in that corner. 33 seconds to go, 89-69 in favor of Las Lomas. A dominating performance here at home in their first home game of the season for Las Lomas. Coach Sly Hunter's got to be very happy with the effort and the productivity of his Knights.
Although there's only 25 seconds left, all the Northgate Broncos can do is hope to foul, get a foul on them or something like that to stop the clock and increase their chances of shooting. But the momentum is clearly on the Knights' side. You can see it as the crowd is waving goodbye already to the Broncos team.
Ball lost here into the corner. Down to 15 seconds to go. Little floater won't go. Banged around Mike Wood. Looks like it's out on him. So the Broncos will keep it for at least one more shot here in the ball game.
If the Northgate Broncos have any win over Las Lomas, though, it was during the football season when they beat him in the first round of NCS. So I think we can say it's fair now.
Ball knocked away, taken back by the Broncos, going right up against Mike Wood. That will do it. A final score from Walnut Creek is the Knights 89 and the visiting Broncos 69, a 20-point win. And really, Brooke, the defense was good. We talked about how they swarmed all game, but really the outside shooting, in particular the three-point shooting of the Knights, just too much for Northgate tonight.
Northgate put all their energy into that first quarter mostly, and they started to fade out towards the end quarters. And you could see Las Lomas take advantage of that small gap and push them out of the way.
They were able to do it really well. Wednesday, the Broncos will be home against College Park. Remember, these two teams will also play again. That'll be on the 28th of this month. That will be at Northgate. For all of us here at Walnut Creek TV, I'm Anthony Schultz, along with Brooke Kilgore, saying good night from Las Lomas.
Have a good night.